Two breaded pork tenderloins.
Thanks, Joe.
On the house, Paul.
Thanks, buddy.
What is this?
Breaded pork tenderloin? Come on, bro. This is an Indiana staple. It's also the only sandwich that can double as its own plate. Look at the size of that thing.
Yeah.
Man, all the big food shows have been gagging to get a piece of this here icon for years. But, you know, owner just shoots them off. Old school, Midwest, no desire for celebrity, only the work matters. You need to stop letting Marcus get under your skin, boy. I mean, he's arrogant, but you're so self-conscious, you'll eventually lose. It's going to affect everything you do on the court, and then you're never going to get to the NBA. No, come. We're only having lunch so you can find out how to get out of the city, right?
Look, I'm sorry, man. Okay,
only apologize when absolutely necessary. We need more ambition on this team.
So what's it like, you know, like the league?
No different to this. Yeah, players are faster, they can jump higher, courts still the same size. Better hotels. You wanna know how to get in?
Deal with Marcus, you know, like make sure he doesn't mess up my chances with the scouts.
Here's an idea. How about you see Marcus as not a rival, but more of a teammate?
Why? He's not going to.
I mean, like, I grew up in Houston, okay? I was a Rockets fan, do or die. That was my team. You know, still is deep down. But you, young players, you were brought up in the system. You probably traveled around the country, you know, in camps, in tournaments, yeah. And you were probably shuffled around by the AAU. You probably never really had a team, right?
Yeah, the Lakers, of course, the Heat.
Yeah, I'm not talking about respect. I'm talking about love. Okay, a love that charges you, feeds you, and that is the difference between a player and a legend. Show them at Ants that you're not just passing through. You show them that passion, the appreciation. And I promise you, none of the time you spend here will be wasted.
What's up?
You're Paul Tatum, right?
Yeah.
Look at that, man. You still get recognized, as you should.
You're AI.
Yeah. Hey.
Both of you guys are like my favorite player on the Mad Ants.
Mad Ants? You a fan?
I'm Zach Coleman. Guys, it's the Mad Ants! It's the Mad Ants!
Mad Ants!
I told you it was them!
Fans of the Mad Ants?
Yeah, man, are you kidding? I mean, yeah. We watch every single game. This season has been so freaking exciting, dude. It's so awesome to know you guys are definitely going all the way.
Whoa, okay, let's just slow it down. It's long season.
You're right, Mr. Tatum. You know, one game at a time, but man, AI... I've seen you be under way worse pressure, and you always come through. When you hit that baseline jumper with 2 seconds left to send it to OT in that tourney game you played, man, legendary. Ice water in your veins.
Thank you, man.
Speaking of which, you guys good? You need a refill? It's on me.
Wait. So you know about me. You know how I deal, huh?
Honestly? If I can speak honestly.
Sounds like you can.
I grew up in this town my whole life, but I feel like I know this world, man. I know the game. Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, but I consider myself like a social media maven. I know how silly that sounds coming out of my mouth, but I'm serious, dude, look.
Let me see this, man. Oh, look, you got 50,000 followers? Yo, what did you say you did?
51.4, but everything, dude, ad campaigns, I boost the social media presence of all these local businesses. Right now, I'm driving people to the Wayne Grove. I'm helping this small coffee shop down by the river. They're outselling even the big guys by the courthouse, dude. But even if they weren't blowing up, I would make sure they were blowing up. But sometimes, it's just great to support a product that you actually believe in.
Yeah.
You know, a coffee refill would be good.
I'm really close to this business being big enough to quit this job, but enough about me. What about you guys? I mean, the Mad Ants and you, AI, you guys don't have a social media presence. Nothing comes up.
I've been a little busy playing basketball. Don't really have time for
much. I'm not saying
that
you should worry about it, but maybe I should be worrying about it, man. Ever since you threw down that sick dunk on Corey Harris in Shanghai, you've been a social media ghost. I mean, do you have a social media manager? Because I could be your social media manager. Or just your regular manager if you don't have one of those.
You know what? I don't, but thank you, though. Appreciate
hey,
that.
Cool, yeah. Cool. All right. Think about it.
Do I still think about it? Yeah, of course I still think about getting that midseason call to be the 12th man. And I'm always going to think about it. Maybe I'll get that one last ride. But you wanted advice. Be here. Now. Don't worry about what's coming.
Good to Fort Wayne, she'll pay you back in full.
Coach cleaned up.
Yeah.
Listen, man, you saw them at the diner. Okay, we are kings around here. And yeah, sure, everyone in the NBA is a king too, but here it's different. You know, it's like your family's filling the stands in the high school gym. It's just a couple of farm boys playing one-on-one. Hey, what do you say to a couple of kings taking on the common folk in the game against the barn door?
Hey, y'all need two more?
Yeah, come on.
Yeah, come on.
It's on, brother.
Salve, salve, galera! Beleza? Aqui é o Jota para mais um vídeo do canal. De volta com o nosso NBA 2K19. Nosso modo carreira, moleque, ó. Tá de civil hoje. Tá de civil? Tá de amigo, né? Passando aqui um pouco um tempo com o Paul Tatum. Mano, esse Paul Tatum provavelmente é o melhor personagem aqui do Prelude, velho. Eu tô gostando demais dos conselhos que ele tá dando pro nosso moleque. Nosso CB, né, cara? O CB que às vezes tem problema... É, às vezes não, tem muito problema de ser arrogante, né, cara? O cara, mano, o moleque não tem nenhuma paciência pra jogar na China ou na G-League, no caso, né, na D-League. Mas o moleque quer estar na NBA, mas assim, ele tá sendo muito apressado, né, cara? Tá todo mundo falando isso, eu lembro. O cara dos Vingadores lá falou que ele não aprendeu a engatinhar, no caso, só a correr, né? Então ele é muito acelerado. E o Tatum, que é esse, o careca aí, mano, ele tá sendo um bom companheiro de time, né? Tá sendo aquele cara... que dá os conselhos que o moleque precisa ouvir para poder evoluir na carreira, para poder aprender a ser humilde, aprender a respeitar os outros. Por exemplo, quando ele falou sobre o Yang, né, ele falou que a gente precisa parar de deixar o Yang entrar na nossa cabeça, senão a gente vai se perder facilmente. Isso é verdade, né, cara? Os jogadores da NBA, eles não passam por trash talk, né? As verdadeiras lendas, no caso, né? É claro que isso acontece uma vez ou outra, assim, mas, cara, você tem que aprender a ficar externo a isso. Olha que jogada. Ai, não, caiu. Você tem que aprender como é que eu posso dizer? A ignorar isso, cara. Ignorar a influência de outros caras dentro de quadra no seu jogo, né, cara? Então é uma coisa que o CB tem que aprender a lidar com o Yang, no caso. O Yang fica discutindo com ele pra caramba, né? Falando que o time é dele e tal. Você tá entrando na mente dele, fazendo apostas pra ver quem faz mais pontos, não sei o quê. Discutindo no vestiário, já quase trocaram porrada. Então, assim... Esse cara, o Paul Tatum, né, no caso aí, o nosso companheiro de time, ele tá sendo primordial na carreira do menino Banks. Olha que jogada no post, mano. Em breve, hein, como eu já falei, teremos uma série de pivô no canal, hein. Então, assim, é óbvio que esse cara tem que ser mais explorado, né, cara. Teve várias cenas com ele aí, agora, olha o release perfeito. Então ele, tipo, virou amigo do cara, tá ensinando como o Banks vai chegar na NBA, né, mano. Aprender a pisar no sapatinho lá na NBA... ficar mais humilde, respeitar os companheiros de time, né? Ele falou que uma ideia boa era não ver o Yang como rival, mas sim como um companheiro de time, né? Que ele não precisa idolatrar e nem ser amigo, mas precisa respeitar, né, cara? Precisa ser companheiro de time. É mais ou menos... Isso me lembra um pouco da relação do Kobe com o Shaq, né, cara? Que muitos diziam que tinha um problema, principalmente nos últimos anos, mas dentro de quadra os caras se respeitavam, né, cara? Então tem que ser assim, mano. Que eu acredito que isso aconteça muito na NBA, né? Os caras... assim, nem tudo é como, tipo, no time da escola, né, velho? Que todo mundo é melhor amigo. Os caras realmente, alguns não se gostam, mas se respeitam em prol do time, né, cara? Em prol do cara ser um vencedor, ser campeão, no caso aí. Ficou bem claro na relação do... Ó, vou passar. Me solta, velho. Ó! Então, assim, ficou bem claro no caso da relação do Shaq com o Kobe, né, cara? Assim, que eu não sei maiores detalhes, porque eu não sou torcedor e li bem pouco sobre... Quer dizer, não foi pouco que eu li, não. Eu li bastante até, mas... eu não sei exatamente os detalhes da relação, se era tão arranhada assim, porque no fim... a gente tem sempre aquela história... A gente já conhece, né, cara, que... O cara teve que escolher entre o Shaq e o Kobe, né? Aí o Shaq... Dizem, né? Não posso confirmar com tais palavras. Shaq disse que pra onde ele iria... Não sei se foi o Shaq ou se foi alguém que disse que pra onde o Shaq iria... E iria ser campeão e acabou acontecendo, né, cara? Que ele foi pro Miami e acabou sendo campeão. Então, assim, tudo isso pra dizer que a relação com esse careca aí, com o companheiro de time, com o Paul Tatum, que tem nome, é muito boa pro menino CB, né, cara? Pro crescimento do moleque, que é só jovem, né, mano? Que jogada maravilhosa. Que isso, que monstro.
Really need to be there the whole time?
Oh, this is so bogus. We already have 3 road games coming up. Now we gotta deal with this?
What's going on?
Directions to the Indiana State Fair. Charity booth again. Coach says we gotta take shifts, man, the meet and greet.
Says we with the Pacers group.
Dude, we'll be lucky to get near the cheerleading section. They do this every year. The Pacers get a choice position between the Ferris wheel and the Gravitron. They stick us at the end of the corn maze.
It could be fun. You know, meet with some local fans, make some new ones. All my time in Shanghai, I never even left my apartment.
Fairgrounds are nowhere near Shanghai, man.
No. No fried chocolate brownies in China.
Hey, who are you and what have you done with AI?
State Fair, right, cuz? Isn't this fun? This is so fun. Oh, I'm having the best time. All right, step right up and get your picture taken with the Mad Ants. The Mad Ants, right here. Okay. Don't worry, guys. Stay positive. We'll get some takers. Anybody want a picture with the Mad Ants? No? Okay. That's not cool. Okay, be quiet. I think I hear somebody in the corn stalks.
Oh, no, it's just a nest of rabbits, Coach. I've been fooled twice already.
Rabbits? Really? How'd they find their way out of the maze? Hey, you know what? You're starting to bum me out with that negative attitude, AI. I think you gotta look on the bright side. We're all having fun here.
Speaking of which, Coach, no one's come out of that maze for like 2 hours. Is there a point we should be like, worried?
Oh, people can get out of there. I mean, I was stuck in there one time for 24, 48 hours, but eventually I ate my way out of there. You can eat as much corn as you want. That's the cool thing. Hey, maybe that's something we could all do. We could all go in there as like a team building exercise, right? Wouldn't that be fun? Where's Howie and Paul?
I think they went up front to see how much long until the fair was over.
Until the fair's over? Okay, now listen up! I'm sick and tired of people asking when the fair's gonna be over! We're all here to have fun! I'm having a great time! We should all be having a great time! Sorry. Shouldn't have yelled. Should not have yelled. Hey, AI, here comes some people. All right, put your smiles on. Let's get some pictures. Go on, you're up.
Yes, sir.
Sorry I yelled at you.
Ooh, hey, they said that there was a deep fried butter booth around here.
Oh, yum.
Hey, guys, did you want a picture?
Yes. Oh, my God, that'd be so amazing.
Let's do it.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Here, let's bring it in. Come on.
Yeah, like from over there would be really great.
Oh,
thanks.
Just you guys.
This is my good side. Wait, no, this side. Okay. Hashtag corn maze.
Hashtag grateful.
Got it.
Oh, my God, thank you.
Oh, don't use the filter. That makes my face look like old carpet.
Oh, that's not the filter.
Oh.
Yeah,
yeah, real funny. I'm not talking to anyone for the rest of the day.
Oh, come on, man. Look at it like this. If we lose tomorrow, it'll only be the second most embarrassing thing to happen to you this week.
Really, Coach?
I'm just joking.
Yeah, I need to go to the bathroom.
Which one are you going in?
Corn maze.
The corn maze is not a bathroom.
Little help there, big fella? Wow. Nice throw. Crisp chest pass. Old school. I like that. That feels like you might have the skills for a little ball.
No, man, I'm good.
I know you're good. I can tell. You have the look of a winner. What I'm asking you to do is prove it now and sink some shots. What do you say?
No, man, I'm good. I got somewhere to be. Next time, though. All right, I'm gonna keep my $5 for now.
Okay. Look, I can tell you're a man of uncommon intelligence and savvy, so for you, my best deal. Check it out. $3, 4 balls.
Thank you, man.
Oh, come on, man. Get a prize. The girl you're trying to impress here.
You heard him. Impress me.
Uh-oh, the gauntlet is thrown.
You want me to sing some shots, huh?
Mainly I'm just trying to score that stuffed elephant that's hanging on that back wall there.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You sure it's, not the green one? I mean, I know it's smaller, but I don't know. Something about those eyes.
Okay. I kind of see it. There's something there. An underdog. Let's get it.
Okay, great. You got to sink 4 shots in a row twice to get that one.
Oh.
Oh, such a tall order. I don't know. What do you think?
If I didn't know any better, I'd say y'all were working me for both sides.
The shot clock's ticking.
Let's both shoot. When we shoot together, then she gets the green one. Does that work for you?
In the name of love, here we go!
Mm-hmm. All right, all right.
One down for the lady.
Tough luck.
Not as easy as it looks.
Wow, you ain't playing.
Another make for the lady.
Aw, I thought you had that one.
Gentlemen falling behind here. And she's not letting up.
No kidding.
Nerves get you on that one?
Doesn't appear to be your game, sir.
Well.
Man. Might as well get this over with.
You said it.
Could you just back up a bit, please? Just
doing my job. Ah, tough luck, boss. A nail biter. But in the end, a loss is a loss. Open for another go?
Nah, that's it, man. I know when I'm beat. You got a real shot. I'm impressed. And I don't know what happened to me. It's my job to make those, man. I must have been nervous.
I'm thinking less about the nerves and more about the elbow flare on your release.
Oh, okay, so you are a ringer then?
I mean, let's just say I'm a firm believer in the fundamentals.
All right, see, that sounds like something that only a player would say. So what's the real resume here?
Huh? I was a starter in high school and bench warmer in college, which coincidentally is also the name of my still unwritten memoir. What about you? What's making the shots a part of my job thing?
I'm a mad ant. It's the local basketball team in the G League.
Yeah, no, I'm aware of them. I've been to a couple games. I just, I don't recall reading about how the ants were signing a player with frayed nerves, though.
Okay, shots fired. Wow, throwing shade at a total stranger on day one. Okay, I see you.
My friends and enemies call me Nikki.
AI. Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Where have you been, Smiler? Huh? Playing carnival games?
Yeah, everyone was saying you needed some alone time after Coach cut through your paper-thin skin. Oh, their words.
All right, free information, gentlemen. You were looking at a man who has just secured a date.
Oh, no. With a carny?
No, not with...
Oh, you don't want to mess with that, man. They're transients, squatters, and they know how to work the fringes of the law. You can't get rid of them.
All right, I promise one of these days you're going to make a joke worth laughing at, Howie. I promise you. I'm going to shake your hand when you do.
Yeah, I don't think it was a joke.
Yeah, but let's just call it a cautionary tale.
Hey, Zach. It's Zach, right?
Yeah, AI.
Hey, how you doing, man?
Dude.
Good to see you.
So right after you left, I got to thinking, what if I could cut together some clips from some of your sickest plays over the last couple of years and make a sizzle reel? Now, there's not a whole lot online, but I was able to track some down. What do you think?
Oh. Man, where did you find all this?
Man, I just told you, I made it.
Wait, you made this just since we met, at lunch?
Yeah, it doesn't take long. Rip some clips, editing software, add some music, done.
And you can put all this on social media?
I can make this set fire to social media, like crash sites. Maybe not actually do that, you know. I have this problem with overpromising. I'm trying to catch myself when I start to do it. But we're doing pretty good so far, man. 1,500 retweets already.
People are taking notice.
We're gonna make them take notice, dude. You give me a couple days.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Hey, would you like to be my new social media rep?
Full time?
I mean, don't get ahead of yourself. Also, I can't get ahead of myself since I can't really afford full time, so...
Hey, no worries. I'm gonna be working all the time anyway.
All right. Well, come to the game tomorrow then.
I will be there. And maybe try and hit some stuff to help me diversify the reel, like assists. Maybe a triple-double?
I'll see what I can do.
All right.
All right, baby.
Hey.
Come to the corn maze with me. Yeah, I hear it's a totally different experience if you go through the exit and the corn's kind of looking away from you.
How are you?
It's very, very awesome. Come on. Tay-Tay, you come too. You can come.
Well, he did not just call me Tay-Tay.